So I'm going to start with the pen tool. And to do that, and I'll just use my finger first, right? I'm going to choose this pen tool. So let's look at some of the features of that, right? And I can push things with my finger or the Apple Pencil. It doesn't matter either way. So the first, if I see just the dot, I'm going to click that, right? And so it brings up a way to see how thick I want to actually write and draw. So if I click here, right, I got that. If I click down here, right, I click that. So you kind of have to choose kind of what you're looking for. All right, so I don't want any of those, so I'm going to undo, which I'll get more into the undo later. And let's go to there for now. And I go over there now. All right, next down, I click that. It gives me some options, right? So it gives me this marker or pen tool, right, that there. Then it also gives me a pencil tool. So if you're looking for kind of a different look, right, or a different thing, you could use that, a different darkness, right? So whether it be 2B, HB, whatever, 6B. And so if you write that, right, now I can still make that bigger and still use, right, and so there, shading, right, that sort of thing. You could do that. All right. Now, the next thing that is there is a ruler. So I can click the ruler, right? As you can see, it lets me go from both pencil and pen from the ruler. I'm going to just go back to the pen for now on the ruler. All right. So with the ruler, what it does is it's there until you untoggle it, right? So I could actually leave this screen and just use my pencil. And I could use that to make a straight edge. I have to go a little bit above. There we go. There I made my straight edge. What's also nice is you can use two fingers and you can turn it. And as you can see, it kind of gives you the angle, right? So I'm going to go at a 45 degree angle. And actually, it snapped at a 45 degree angle. That could be very helpful. Again, I missed it. I'm going to go a little bit above. There we go. And then that would be... that would be where that is. Okay, so with that, right, I'm using my ruler. I could use it. I could make some. There we go. Right, so it looks like I'm starting to do some geometry. Should I just finish it off, right? And I, even with the ruler out, I could still kind of do this sort of thing, right? Even with the ruler out. Now, if I want to get rid of the ruler, I'm just going to click back on where that pen tool is and hit the ruler, and then it disappears. All right. So that is kind of the most basic part of this, of that thing. The next thing here, that is a fill tool. All right. And with that, though, before I get into that, let's actually talk about the colors. So as you can see, I've just used black so far. So I can click, though, on any of these colors and change. So now I can do red. And I can say, well, I know this was 45 degrees. Right? So I could do red, right, blue, and so on. All right, now, but if I click, when if I'm on a color and then I click it again, that brings up the option to change the colors. So I have these kind of standard 8 colors in the middle. Then it kind of went away since I didn't do anything with it. All right, so I have these right in the middle. I also have the opacity, right? How transparent I want the drawing to be. Maybe I want it to be a little bit kind of, I want to see what I'm drawing on top of underneath it, right? So that might be a good reason to kind of change the transparency or the opacity. Then here is where I can make custom colors. And what I do is hit the plus sign. And then I could actually use anything on this circle. Right, I could do anything on that circle and make that a custom color. Now, I also can make it darker. So I could go ahead and do... I'm going to just use my finger there. All right. I could go to this mode as well, right? And I could actually put in the hex, the RGB color. So if you have an exact color brand or that you want to be using or to support a certain... team or whatever, you could do that. For example, let's say I want to support an ad, use exact scarlet, and so I'm going to say BB, and then 0000, and then that'll bring up the exact color that I would be looking for right there. All right. Now, what you also will notice is that there's the stroke, and then there's also the fill. The fill would be what would be inside of it when you decide to fill up the shape, okay? And this happens with all of the different tools. They kind of have a stroke or border and then fill. So here with fill, I can do the same thing. I could also use this eyedropper. This eyedropper would be a great way I could look around kind of the screen and find a color. And so there, obviously, I only have a couple colors so far. But one nice thing you could do is you could actually bring in an image maybe. And we'll talk about how to do that later. And you could actually eyedrop from there. And we'll do that later so I could show you what that looks like. And that way you can kind of complement the image or part of the image and have that together in that sense. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and say done there. All right, cool. So now what I could do, though, is that when I make a shape, I could then hit this little fill tool. And what that will do is then fill in your shape. And you could do that with all sorts of shapes, right? So you could, I could even go back to say black, and I could choose to fill it with pink. Perfect. I like it. All right. And then what I can do is make any sort of odd shape. Don't know what that is, but that's okay. But then I'm going to fill it in, and it fills in that way. All right. So that's the fill tool. The last tool that is there within the pen tool, and why don't we just go on to a new and up in the corner apparently, which is fine. We're going to go and try to make another shape. So I'm going to go ahead and do this. All right, and then I'm going to add, I'm going to make this a three-dimensional box. There we go. Cool. All right, now, this last thing is a check mark. And the check mark kind of, what it says is it completes the shape. It brings all those pieces that you lines you drew and kind of makes them one.